Chad Morton again. He's back inside the 10. Better kick this time. Well covered by the Broncos. 4-yard run to bring us to this point at 23-17. Blitz and is open, and Barber unable to hold on.
Tiki Barber, nobody covered him, and I'll tell you why there's nobody covered him, because everybody is blitzing to Eli Manning's right side. So if Tiki Barber could have caught that, look at John Lynch again. Al Wilson from way off. And it works against the Giants again, just because they do hold the football longer than most teams.
Manning a week ago led the Giants down the field in two plays to send a game into overtime. Now he hits Burris out at the 23-yard line as we approach 3 minutes and a big third and four on the way.
Third and four, 3 minutes, over 3 minutes to go. You have two timeouts. I think it's you're almost in the four down situation. You have to go for it, even if you don't hit this third down play here.
Identical to a late hookup with Burris against the Cowboys last week.
Yeah, that was a good job by Eli Manning. Not panicking when he went to the right, reversed his field, and looked to his favorite receiver, Plexico Burris.
Clock is running at 2:18. A first down for the Giants. And they stopped the action. Broncos want to settle down.
32nd timeout.
Plus they've got Darrent Williams down on the field. Giants down six with 2:13 remaining, with two timeouts and a first down from the 29. That's up ahead to the 36 and a gain of seven. And looks like they'll let it run down to the 2 minute warning. 2 minutes to go. The Broncos trying to hold on for a sixth win in a row. 2 minutes left, and Burris is on the sidelines.
After that big third down catch, the Denver defenders landed on him, and his collarbone, the doctors have been checking him out. Be curious to see if he comes back in.
But you saw Darrent Williams is back in. A run for the first with Barber out to the 42. Gain of six, and they're going to hurry to the line.
Plexico Burris comes back in.
Comes back in, then runs back off. First down, Giants, 42-yard line. Open man is Barber. And he's near the first down. They'll spot him, it looks like, about a foot shy. Right between Gold and Foxworth.
Tough decisions to make if you're playing defense. Do you try to play the clock, or do you go after the quarterback? So far, they're playing the clock.
Second and short, pass, first down, Toomer stays in bounds with 1:15. Remember, the Giants have two timeouts.
Yeah, still plenty of time. Don't panic. They're not. Keep taking the short ones. The opportunity to go down the field will come up as soon as Denver gambles.
Burris back in on first down, and it's back over to Toomer, and he's down at the 35, near another first. Timeout call this time with 51 seconds, leaving the Giants with one timeout. Well, we've got here second and one with 51 seconds, and the ball at the 35. Tiki Barber telling us on Friday, we feel like we should win every week. And he says Eli this year is not second guessing himself at the line. It's a different attitude.
Here they come. Looks like Denver might change and come with a blitz this time.
They'll run for the first. Barber has it at the 31, and they'll hurry back to the line. Now inside of 40 seconds. No spike. Manning left side and Burris. No, did not get the second foot down. 34 seconds.
The Giants, when you watch them play this season, this passing game, I've told you many times, they like to throw it down the field. When they get inside the 35, Tom Coughlin believes, take a shot. Somebody can run a double move, throw it deep down the field, try to get in the end zone. In practice on Friday, they had many plays that did exactly that.
From the 32. Going for the big one. Down the field for Carter, and incomplete. Boy, there was some contact, but no flag.
That's what they did. It looked like Tim Carter to the outside gave a little move trying to get deep down the field. And you're right, Jim, there was quite a bit of contact in the end zone. Going against Dominique Foxworth. Boy, that's close. Oh, good job by Foxworth. That's why there's no penalty called, because he turns and looks for the football.
Crowd gasps, I should say, when it sees the replay go through the fingertips. Would have been a very tough catch. Third down, and Manning has Shockey, his first catch of the second half, and it's a big one. Out of bounds at the 8. Well,
if you keep going with the blitz, that means you have somebody covering Jeremy Shockey one-on-one. Here comes the blitz. Ian Gold up the field. What a nice move by Jeremy Shockey. He looked inside. Ian Gold started to look for the football, and he realized it's too late. He broke outside.
The game plan all week, practice all week, and it's coming down to a couple of plays. From the 8-yard line, 21 seconds. Fake to Barber, across the middle, and too low, and very nearly picked up by Darren Williams. That was intended for Amani Toomer, and he is now going to have to come out.
Well, that football, Darren Williams coming out, that football fell out of Eli Manning's hand. And that's why the throw was low.
Seconds. Burris, he's got Bailey on him at the top of the screen. Huge height advantage for Plexico on that left side. Manning across the middle. It's Barber. Barber collides at the 2 with 10 seconds. Timeout. Boy, they lost a couple of seconds there as Lynch and Gold come up to converge on Barber at the 2-yard line. And the Giants now are out of timeouts. 8 seconds. Ball at the 2. They've added a couple of seconds now.
That's big, because that allows the Giants at least 2 plays. If they throw it in the end zone.
Manning. Looking, here comes the pressure, pass away, catch is made, it's Toomer again against the Broncos like he did back in 98. Mike Shanahan brought his team in here 7 years ago, 13-0 undefeated, and Toomer caught a Kent Graham pass in the final minute to end the unbeaten season of the Broncos.
Eli Manning gave himself some extra time by just backpedaling, and it allowed Amani Toomer to come across the field.
Now the extra point. Field drills it. 24-23 Giants.
Amani Toomer unhappy with his role in this offense. Look at me sometimes. That's what he said. He comes across the field. Nobody's open. Oh, and way to attack the football by Amani Toomer. Watch Eli Manning. Nobody open left. Just keeps going back. Finally sees him, and he throws. throws it soft.
And he leaps across Dominique Foxworth for the catch. And in all likelihood, the win. Eli celebrates as the Giants drive down the field. 83 yards in 3 minutes and 24 seconds.